Or no, no, see, no, no, or no, if you want to do it complex, you can do it like no kind of a formula and whatever it is, you know, which will again do the same thing. Because usi cell mein dono kaise dikh sakte hain? You are asking.
You are being representing, right?
Yeah. Yeah, fine. So I understand. So, but
copy the column and then do it, or else equal to.
See, one thing is sure that you can't see both the things in one cell, right? So that's how it is. Okay, so ye ho gaya. And then okay, so now I think see these things only when you have the laptop and all it will be easier. So I'll just run through this. You guys have used the round function. Right, no, so round function you know, right? Is equal to round. नहीं है तो नहीं पता है बोलो यार ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. आई एम ऑल्सो बेसिक यूजर. नो बिकॉज इट विल बी आई हैव फाइव मिनट्स मोर, 5 to 10 minutes. दे हैव नॉट गिवन मी मच टाइम. सो ओके, आई विल जस्ट टेल यू अगेन. 100 × 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, राइट? सो अभी कैसे, वेन यू डिवाइड नो दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स विल कम. सो इफ यू जस्ट वॉन्ट टू कन्वर्ट इट टू राउंड, यू कैन जस्ट राउंड इट बाय द नंबर दिस. Then, like no, for example, I want it only 2 digits. Okay, so the round thing and the max thing is again like no, in a series, it will ask for the max, which is the max number. Right? So minimum again, that is the use. Large, a small. Right? Average again, it gives an average. Like no, I'll just done this. So the average of this, understood? Right? Most of them use this. Then the sum, the length. Length, like for example, sometimes what happens is this is a very important feature, you know, the length thing. If you want to understand a length and then divide, there is like adding different formulas together, putting different formulas together. So those are advanced, but this is the basic thing, length. Like for example, aap yahan pe dekhoge to like it is RAM is see here only how much is it?
Three letters.
But what is the length of the cell?
13.
Right. So what happens is when we put a VLOOKUP, right? So and the spaces are there, it will not take, and it will show a different value, right? So for that we have something called trim. So what I have done is I have done the trim function is equal to trim and then that cell. So that will give me now. See now if you see it shows 3 only, right? So this is very important function which you can use. Then if error and is error, wherein like no, for example, if you want to remove the errors thing, you can put is equal to if error formula and then replace it. So it will remove the NAs, DU and all if it comes, right? So AND function, this is also a very good function which can add 2 values. I think most of them know, right? I am not getting any feedback only. Yeah, you know, right? AND function. I am not showing this. If you want to know, you can just tell me. VLOOKUPs. You want to, yeah, I can show, but I will show it, but the only issue is that you should do it, then only you'll understand. So I will still try to show this VLOOKUP. Like for example, one more thing, like a basic function. If you want to go to a previous sheet, how do you go with the keyboard? No sheet. Yeah, so it's the easiest way is control page down, page up. Okay, so you can do it. So now like for example, this is my data column, right? Yahan pe country hai, categories hai, like no, developing advances and the years, right? So now if what happens is most of the time you might be wanting in a different sheet wahi data chahiye, right? So and when the data rows are like no, 50,000, 10,000, you can't sit manually and do it, you know. So for that it is very useful, this VLOOKUP function. We look up, you go to the column which you want, okay, select that, then put a comma, then we have like for example this, select the range what you want, okay, and then come down till wherever you want, and then again which column, comma, then which column, like which column you want, this 1, 2, 3, because if you select the entire thing, I want the second column, right? So it has shown me the advance, right? It's an advanced country. Okay, believe me, I have worked with a very big organization wherein there were people who at a very they were not super users of the Excel, they had 50,000 rows and they used to like, you know, sit and do manually. So there are people who still do it. So if possible, try to help those kind of people. So it will save lots of man hours. And at the end of the day, like, you know, it's a headache. It's still a mistake, you know. So like that. So this is a VLOOKUP function, which looks very easy when you see now. But once you start doing it, you will not be able to figure out. So just try. Okay. So this is about it. So you just copy paste it. It will come. Right. See, okay, this is where I wanted to show you the trim function. You know, if you see here, this 15 is there, but still it is coming like NA. If you see here, the space is there. You understand? If I put the cell, okay, I think there I have removed it. Okay, I can show it for this. See, now this I have included space, it will not, the data will not come. That's because of the space. So this is for the V lookup, and H lookup is the horizontal one, right? So this is about it. And yeah, so V lookup ho gaya, H lookup ho gaya, and then like now we have the, okay, now this is, okay, I have a sheet wherein I have put lots of formulas. So अभी मुझे चेक करना है कौन से शीट में फॉर्मुलास है सर, एनी आइडिया? आई हैव लॉट्स ऑफ फॉर्मुलास बीइंग पुट नो. अभी मुझे लाइक नो आई वांट टू फिगर इट आउट विच सेल इज हैविंग अ फॉर्मुला एंड विच सेल आई डोंट हैव अ फॉर्मुला. सो देयर इज अ इजी वे यू नो बिकॉज यू डोंट नो दिस इज अ वेरी यूजफुल फंक्शन बिकॉज समबडी लाइक नो माय डायरेक्टर कम्स एंड आस्क मी ओके अभी दिखाओ तो आई एम सो अफ्रेड दैट आई डोंट नो विच सेल द फॉर्मुलास आर देयर यू नो. सो व्हाट विल हैपन देयर इज अ इजी वे कंट्रोल इफ यू डू इट विल show this
control
of 1k besides me jo hai na comma aise tilde ha so tilde ha sir so tilde up whatever it is so you control wo karenge to ye aapko mil jayega and that will be it's very useful because you can see easily. So now coming after coming here how do you go back?
Escape.
No escape kiya na escape is not working. Again control data, so it's easy, but because I got fixed, you know, I tried doing so many things and this is again this one.
Okay,
so
in this I want to ask one question.
Right,
like there is a formula for one cell.
Right,
somebody went and edited it by mistake.
Right,
so the formula is gone.
Right,
so how to protect formula field only?
हाँ वही ना वो कंडीशनल जो प्रोटेक्ट शीट्स हाँ प्रोटेक्ट है हाँ
बट इफ इट्स लाइक रैंडम डिफरेंट प्लेसेस इज देयर एनी शॉर्टकट वेयर वी कैन प्रोटेक्ट ऑल द फॉर्मूले फील्ड्स अलोन दैट अलोन विल नॉट बी लाइक यू नो एडिटेबल इज इट पॉसिबल
आई डोंट नो आई हैव नॉट डन इट आई विल हैव टू ट्राई.
This is one problem.
Yeah, this is a very, very good question because otherwise you'll have to control a sheet. But I don't know, means that's my understanding. Whenever you put a formula, it will be for a particular row or a column, you know. It might be like, no, different.
One sheet, some cells, people have to enter data.
Right.
Some cells, it is automatically
computed. Right.
So if this sheet is designed like that,
right.
Sometimes by mistake, people go and change that also.
Right, so that's what I'm saying. So you protect that column.
Okay. So that is manually, we have to do again.
Ah, right. तो एक बार करना है आई डोंट नो इट माइट बी देयर बट आई डोंट नो राइट. सो दिस इज अ गुड क्वेश्चन सो वी कैन सिट लाइक नो पोस्ट
ऑल द
फॉर्मूले. ओके ओके फाइन आई ओके वी विल डू इट लेटर बिकॉज माय बैटरी इज अप. सो दिस लाइक नो फॉर्मूला ये तो यूजफुल फंक्शन है. टेक्स्ट टू कॉलम्स यू नो आई जस्ट शो क्विकली दिस वन. Okay, so now what is happening is this is the data, no? Like that when you take from the like, no, some file, it will come this way, right? So what you have to do is I do it with shortcut, you know, so it becomes very difficult for me to figure out where it is. So I'll have to
you can tell the shortcut also.
No, because no shortcut, if I tell, you'll not understand it, right?
Special, right?
No.
Text to filter, text to
columns. Okay, text to columns. Okay, so यहाँ पे text to column जाने see what happens is it is combined right with that backslash. So you go here data text to columns and then others is there right. यहाँ पे if you put this so it will divide. This very useful function. This is one of the very useful function and इस पे भी you can convert it to text and all those are advanced thing which you can know later right. Is it clear? दिखा है ना CDS
slash only it is there, the first one.
Right.
How about the
rest? Is divided, no, in a different. See, now what is happening is, see, when I took the data, it was like no text slash CD bar, aise tha, right? So I want it separately, textless. You know, this is very important, you know, because VLOOKUP data, it will not allow you. So you want a particular specific field. See, there are other things also, like, you know, right. Okay, I have not shown that right, left, and all those. On that basis also you can take. No. What we will do is, I will take another 5 minutes, because see, it's a lunch time, so I'm actually bugging them up, and I took the session. So what we can do is, we can sit later also once again, and you probably can tell others, so that who can join, you know, because Excel is very, very useful and many people use it. So I feel that most of them should take the benefit of it. And being in bar camps, I am coming from bar camp 3. So I just wanted to share this small thing which I know. So understood, right? So your doubt is clear. Whose doubt was that?
Can I
have CDS? Your doubt.
No, he is asking the item sales, those two columns is already separated.
No, he is talking only about the fourth
data
column.
To text, right?
Yeah.
So if I do a data to text, what does it mean? Means for me, I'm saying I'm just removing the slash, the
exactly.
backward slash, and then with all the data.
And so you have separated it.
So what is that you?
Column.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That
is
it.
What is that you want? What is your requirement?
No, I understood. Basically, you do it again, I think. That's
okay, so.
Yeah. That's
so it's E and F. It's a different.
So if I want to have it in the same column, not possible.
So same column mein chahiye na, what you can do is, you can just, kya kar sakte sir?
Replace.
So it's something. So it's a unique thing. No, that's just again, lots of logic.
Yes.
Understood. No? So this is again the basic stuff, and this may be kuch hai, wherein right, left, all those combinations you can do. Fine. So this is about it. Text, pivot tables.
Yes.
Yes, I
can
do it. I don't know.
Can we take it later? Or we still want it because.
Continue.
Because no. Why I'm saying is everybody will miss out the lunch because they have given. After that, they will not give the lunch. I'm just asking for the people. So why I'm saying is, after that, now we can come together and take one more session if it is required. No, if you are still okay with that, I can continue.
Yeah, continue.
Okay, fine.
Are you
I do it by keyboard shortcuts, no, so it becomes a problem for me.
Data, right?
This location. Then you go here. Right, it's you select the range whatever you want, and then you come here, and for example yahan pe aa gaya, right? So this is how it will come in the 2007, right? So abhi from which we came. Okay, you should talk here, then it will be better. So what is that you want? So what is the your requirement in pure table? What is that you want to see? Sorry?
X and Y axis.
No, that is a different thing. So what, just imagine
sales,
I'm from, yeah, so business, you are a top guy, you know. I want to know kitna hua sales.
Sales of t-shirts.
Right.
Just
only
t-shirts. T-shirt ka sales, right. I did in this sales. We'll have lots of columns, but I have kept only one column. So now Abhi, for example, you want sales of t-shirts, right. So what you can do is, you put the item. Right, so you put, and you want the sales, right?
Yeah.
So sales, you put it here. You drag and drop this. I think this is clear, right? So in this, again, we can do lots of advanced thing, you can count bhi kar sakte hai, and then lots of other things, permutations and combinations. And okay, now you said only t-shirts you want, right? So what you have to do is, you can just go here and select the t-shirt one. Yes, aggregate, it's basically for the presentation thing, lots of data can be pulled together and it can be seen in an OLAP way, which is it's a very dynamic way, of seeing the data points. Like, for example, if you had seen in the other data, see, aggregation is one part of it, so in the other column, in the data sheet, you could have not known a t-shirt sale is how much. Over here, it is just drag and drop. So it's more about analyzing things as you want. Okay. Is it clear? So isme sir, you want to add anything else?
Can you have, can I have the GUI part?
Pivot chart. Yeah. You want to see the pivot chart option.
I want to see the chart option.
The pivot chart, yeah, which is there on the
That we'll do later, no? Because I'll have to cover lots of things. So this is the basic thing. Okay, so isme again you can like put formulas and derive some information and all those things, right? So I think this is clear, na?
Yeah.
So pivot table, so just for your basic information, and then right. Okay. Pivot charts is again the same thing. That I will talk later. I will take lots other things which are there. Grid lines, okay. Grid lines. See, now what happens is whenever we open Excel sheet, it will come like this. This, so this you know, right? The grid lines, removing the grid lines. Do you know?
View grid lines. View we can go ahead.
Yeah. So you can just remove the. It looks better, you know.
Correct.
It looks like this. So you can remove the grid lines. Understood. So this is one of the useful feature, grid lines, and okay, data validation. Data validation. Have you done? You are done, right? Okay. Data validation is very good stuff. Like for example, today's for Barcamp, we have Barcamp organizers want put the name, and they want like not the category, right? So they just want the category of like for example, tech, business, design, social, right? So data validation will help you. Like for example, if I want to come and put like something like movies. It will not allow me because those are the only options. So data validation will help you to give only those categories which you want. So data validation.
Data validation.
Yeah. So what you can, you have to first write this. Like for example, you write over here. So I have this, and I want like for example movies. Then match and like learning, right? So if I want to have these categories here, only these three. So what I have to do is, sorry, I have to go to data validation. List, right. That's what I made a mistake. Yeah, this is where you have to go. So this list you have to this one. Right. So this is a very useful functions, especially if you want some people to access only particular column, this one. So I think this is understandable, right? Okay, data validation ho gaya. Then we have this filter. In filter, again, like for example, okay. So in this, I think this most of you guys know, right? So filtering only will you like for example that those things, and we can do advanced filters also, like in terms of on the basis of color and sorting color, as well as like contents, if it contains within certain range and also these are the advanced versions, so that we can talk later. So this is about the filter stuff, right? And the sorting like basically sort the numbers on. Are you guys knowing? Okay, because these are very useful functions if you don't know. Then conditional formatting, it will format on the basis of the color and this one. Okay. Freeze panels, you know, right? So, see, I'll show you. This is a very useful. Like, for example, now what is happening is. Okay. So, now, like, for example, see, Sarji, if you want, like, for example, I want to see the. See, this is the data point, right? Okay, so I want to know, and I came here down.
Yeah.
I don't know which year it is. So how do you figure out? it's very difficult. Again, you'll have to go up and then you get confused where it is gone. So basically what you can do, freeze panels if you do, it will come. So it will freeze only those headers. Right, so these are very useful functions and it can be used very nicely if you, okay, so this is about it. So this, this is under view set, right? Fine, so ye ho gaya, then we'll keep something else for later also. This grid lines are shown, okay. So now I'll show you about the subtotal also. Okay, now this is a very important function, okay, I will just share with you guys. See, this is the data, no? You have data points like this, right? I have just put some countries and like, no, advanced all of this, that and all. So these are the yearly, like, no, they are, for example, sales from that particular country. So what is happening is, I have used something called, most of them might be using the sum function, right? Right?
Yeah, right.
Sum, so what do? Is equal to sum and get the thing. Right, so where is the sum function? So now we put the sum. This is the correct formula of sum, right? Is it correct? Right, so this is sum function.
Yeah.
So what is happening is, now when we put sum, like just imagine it gives the correct numbers to us. Just imagine now you go and see for a poor country. Right, what is happening for sum? Is it showing the sum? It is 86,000, right? But the sales, it is showing around 5 lakh. So, right, the sum function is not working here. So, in this case, what you are going to do? Any idea?
Equals sum of.
Okay. Okay. So, see, I have put like some 3-4 things which you can do for this kind of issue things. One is subtotal. Okay. The formula is subtotal 9. You remember that it is 9. So it will give the subtotal. Now just imagine, the total sales of this is like 5.25, right? But when I go for a developed, advanced, poor country again, the sale is 90. Right? If you see the sale, is it correct?
No.
It's not.
No, it's correct, no?
It's correct, right?
Yeah.
So, but when you put that sum function and try to do it, it will be wrong. So in this case, you should use subtotal 9, right?
So the subtotal will calculate all the 3 years data, all the 390, 91, 92, or only the 90.
No, it will calculate. See, now that formula is there for in this column, right? See, I have put only in these three columns. Here, there is some other formula.
Correct.
So if you want, like for example, if you want the data for the subtotal of this, you have to copy in this column. No. Understood. Yeah, subtotal 9 and then select the range. Okay, the 9 is to subtotal it. Okay, that is the logic.
That is standard.
Yeah, standard for subtotal. Okay, so I am not a trainer, so I might be not knowing the basic funda and all. So, but this is how finally you should get things done. So, that's more important. And you should know the logic also, but at an overview. So, this is for subtotal part of it. Then average. See, average ke liye, then there is something else which is basically 1. The same thing, subtotal, you put 1 and then it will give you the average, right? And then count ke liye 2 hai, right? And then this sum, maximum is 4, minimum is 5, right? So these are the things which you can use, and these are very useful things, you know, and it saves lots of time. So you not have a sleepless night for this, and yeah, so these are the things about subtotal ka wagera, and then yeah, so other things, what I will do is I will just keep my system here with the Excel open, just input all your email ID so that I can share whatever data I have about Excel links and all, so I can send you some inputs and we can like create a group wherein it can be like, no, mutually shared some learnings. So this is from my side. I do have something pure charts and all that we can do later, because those are advanced, that I have to take time. It's just not like, no, just talking and going off. So we'll do like, no, in pure we can do advanced charting thing, data in data also we can do more, so we will do it later, right? And right, so that's about it. Okay, anybody else has some learning which they can share, you know, because where it's this barcamp is like, no, to mutually share and learn more. So I don't know, you guys might have come with lots of your own experiences which has helped you. It might be very small, but then it can be very useful.
Advanced user actually, so not
no, it is not advanced user, sir. Excel, see, I have not gone here, right? So this is my last link. So for they say, right, practice makes perfect, but Excel will make you expert but not perfect, you know. So Excel is so advanced, you know, because when I take interviews, I just ask somebody, you know, how much of Excel you know out of 10, they will say 9. 8, and so I don't know, because it's very difficult, you know. Microsoft conducted an exam and they tested people and they asked, like, you know, who knew, like, somewhere 6-7, you know, and they were passing with 3. So just imagine, those were the experts who have done coding, this, that, you know. So if you have any case scenario wherein you can, like, you know, kind of share and we can mutually learn, and or we can do it later at an advanced level after this.
How do you do a hyperlink?
Okay, that I didn't show, no, right?
Any cell you write it, you will get insert hyperlink.
So you click on that,
yeah.
You have to match that folder.
How is that folder?
See, now you want to come to this.
No, see, now if you want to go, like, for example, if I want to go to a different file, you know, so I go here.
But it's showing this different file, is it?
No, this is in the same sheet. I will show the advanced thing wherein you have to, you can go to a different outside.
That outside we know, but the same sheet I want. Place in this document. Left side is the first column.
Okay, yahan pe. Understood.
Oh, okay.
So
outside usually we do it.
Okay. Outside you'll give the path. Okay, you will not
give the URL. We'll give the path.
Right.
And match that.
Match means?
We'll give the path.
Okay.
In that address bar below.
Okay.
And you hit OK. Then if you click on this hyperlink, it will take you there.
Okay. Now what I used to, in the initial time, is like, no, I used to go to that file. I used to take the path and just copy paste it. You know. So it is, no. That's again a learning. After that, I came to know is you can do it in this way. Now. So this.
Since you are using so many shortcuts, double click on view. You can use this feature.
Okay.
You can avoid the ribbon because you are using all the shortcuts.
Right.
If you double click that again, it
again. Works. So this is learning, you know. So I didn't knew this. So this is it's very basic, but then it's very useful. And there are something like lots of things you can remove this, that, you know, these things. So anybody else, the basic users also can give good ideas, you know. So that's why, and because they are the people who are using it, you know, and because when we get into work, nobody will teach us how to do it and all. So you just do it, okay, and you start working on it.
So on the top, you have that save and undo, right?
Right.
Next to that, you have the small
right.
Ethic button. Yeah.
Right.
There you can go and customize, you can give more commands.
Correct.
Right.
And whatever
right.
frequently you are using, you
using
can
it there.
You can add it and you can remove it.
Yeah.
Okay, Sarji, we'll have to leave because we have lunch time at 1:30.
Yes,
certain. So what time we'll sit again for like an advanced session?
Just open a notepad and we'll
have
an email address.
Yeah, Excel sheet I'll open.
We'll create a user group.
Yeah, just enter quickly. You enter your this one, no? Email ID.
I have a shortcut in Excel. I'll just share it.
What is it?